أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أعظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصابنا بأبي عبد الله، إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. It is the eve of Shami Ghariba, the eve in which we remember Ummul Masaib, Zainab Kubra alayha salam. We have spoken all day about Aba Abdullah al-Husayn and about the martyrs of Karbala. Now it is time to give condolences to Ummul Masaib. One scholar said that Zainab Kubra was given the title of Ummul Masaib because of all the musiba that she saw and she witnessed. Despite all his musiba and difficulties and trials, Aba Abdullah was not given the title Abul Masaib, but Zainab was given the title Ummul Masaib. From a young age, she had been told about Karbala. From a young age, she had been told what to expect, but she would always tell herself that with a brother like Abbas, how can Zainab ever be tied in ropes? How can the women ever be taken as captives? It is said that on the day of Ashura, before Imam al-Husayn goes into the battlefield, he comes for his final wada', he comes for his final farewell. He came to Zainab Kubra. Zainab Kubra told him, "Oh my brother Hussein, you are now going to go and leave us. But before you go into the battlefield, I want you to open your collar." Aba Abdullah al-Hussein opens his collar. Zainab Kubra kisses the neck of Aba Abdullah. And she says, "Oh my brother, this was the wasiyah of my mother Fatima." And she said that before your brother Hussein goes into the battlefield, kiss his neck on my behalf, for this is where the dagger will fall. Ajrukum ala Allah. At that moment, Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam tells Zainab, "Oh Zainab, lift your sleeve." And when she lifts her sleeve, Imam al-Hussein kisses the arms of Zainab. When Zainab asks him, "Oh my brother Hussein, why did you do this?" He says, "This was the wasiyah of my father Ali." He said, "Oh Hussein, your sister Zainab's arms, your sister Zainab's hands will be tied in ropes as she is taken captive to Kufa and to Sham." Ajrukum ala Allah, ajrukum ala Allah. It is said that after the battle, when the bodies of the martyrs were all lying in Karbala, towards the evening time, Umar al-Sa'd commanded that the riders should trample the bodies of the martyrs. As they heard that the bodies were going to be trampled, one after the other, the different tribes people came forward and said, "No, Habib is from our tribe, we will not allow you to trample his body." One tribe came forward and said, "Hur is from our tribe, we will not allow you to trample his body." But nobody came forward and said, "Hussein is the grandson of Rasulullah. We will not allow you to trample his body." The bodies of the Banu Hashim were trampled in Karbala. And after the bodies had been trampled, now the soldiers started going towards the tent. They wanted to loot the tents. As they came towards the tents, they would enter into the tents. They would use their spears to snatch away the veils of the women, and the women were screaming and running from one tent to another as the Ashqiya burnt down the tents after looting them. Finally, all the women ran into the last tent, and all the women were in that tent. It is said that that was the tent of Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam. We are told that at that moment, Zainab alayhi salam asked Imam Sajjad, "You are the Imam of our time, and tell us what we should do. Should we stay in this tent and be burnt alive, or should we move out without our veils and save our lives?" The Imam alayhi salam said, "Saving life is wajib. You must save your life." So all the women came out of the tent. Hamid ibn Muslim says, "I saw that there was a lady entering one last tent as it was burning. She was going in and coming out, going in and coming out. I thought to myself that there must be something very precious inside the tent. Finally, I saw that lady coming out with a sick man. I realized that this was Ali ibn al-Husayn. This was Zainul Abideen. Zainab Kubra had saved the Imam of her time. She had brought Imam al-Sajjad outside the burning tent. Ajrukum ala Allah. Ajrukum ala Allah." Once all the women were outside the tents, the Ashqiya did not leave them. Some women were whipped by the Ashqiya. Some children had their earrings snatched. We are told that Sakina's earrings were snatched from her ear, that she got slaps from Shimmer. This is the same Sakina who saw how her father had treated the daughter of Muslim ibn Aqil with so much love and affection. But now, when she was an orphan, instead of affection, this is how she was treated. Hamid ibn Muslim says, "I saw a little girl. Her dress was on fire. She was running around. I tried to stop her so that I could put out the fire. As I went near her, she said, 'Oh man, I am from the Ahlul Bayt. I am from the Ahlul Bayt. Don't come near me. Don't come close to me.' I said, 'Oh little girl, I only want to put out the fire that is on your dress.' After I had put out the fire, she looked at me and she said, 'I think you are a kind man. You are a kind man. Could you do me one more favor?' Hamid ibn Muslim says, 'Yes, what other favor can I do for you?' Sakina says, 'Show me the direction of Najaf.' 'What will you do going to Najaf, oh little girl?' She says, 'I will go to my grandfather Ali and complain to him about what has happened to us here.' Ajrukum ala Allah. Ajrukum ala Allah. I don't know how Zainab was able to make the children sleep that night, but after all the children were sleeping, now it was time to count the children. As they counted the children, they found that Sakina is missing. We are told that Zainab and Umm Kulthum proceed towards the battlefield looking for Sakina. As they proceed towards the battlefield, they find two young children resting arm in arm. They think that these children are asleep. They try to wake the children only to find that they have been trampled by the horses and they have died in each other's arms. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Look at the dhulm in Karbala. Zainab alayha salam proceeds. She goes towards the qatlgah. She goes towards the place where the bodies of the martyrs are fallen. She calls out, "Sakina, where are you, oh Sakina? Sakina, where are you, oh Sakina?" Finally, she comes to a body. She sees Sakina sleeping next to the feet of a body. She wakes her up, "Sakina, why are you sleeping here?" She says, Sakina, why are you sleeping here? Ajrukum ala Allah. Sakina explains, I was looking for my Baba. I was looking for my father. I ran into the battlefield crying out, Father, oh Baba, where are you? And finally, from this corpse, from this dead body, a sound came, Ilayya, Ilayya, Sakina. Ilayya, Ilayya, Sakina. And so I came to this body, but I could not sleep on the chest of my father, as his chest has been trampled, and that is why I am sleeping at the feet of my father. Ajrukum ala Allah, ajrukum ala Allah. Zainab alayha salam takes Sakina and puts her to sleep with all the other children. Now finally all the children are accounted for, all the women folk are accounted for, but Zainab alayha salam is awake. Now she has to do the work that Abbas would do. She has to be the guardian of all the others. Before this night, Abbas is the one who would stand guard. Now Zainab is doing the work of Abbas with a broken spear in her hand and a torch in her other hand. She is ensuring that everyone is safe. She is standing guard. We are told that suddenly she sees from a distance someone is approaching. Zainab asks, who is it? The answer comes, I am the wife of Hur. The wife of Hur has come. She has brought with her water. She has brought with her food. Zainab alayha salam first gives her condolences to the wife of Hur. O wife of Hur, accept our condolences on the martyrdom of your husband Hur. When the wife of Hur hears this, she begins to weep. She says, oh my lady Zainab, you are giving me condolences. Look at your entire family. How can you be the one to give me condolences? I give you condolences, O granddaughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And then she gives the water and the food. Now when Zainab gets the water, she comes to Sakina. We are told she comes to Sakina. She wakes Sakina up. Oh Sakina, oh Sakina. Sakina wakes up. She says, Sakina, look, water has come. You are very thirsty. Here, have some water. Sakina asks her, oh my auntie, why are you waking me up? All the children are thirsty. She says, no, Sakina, we normally give... She says, oh Sakina, we normally give the youngest child first. The youngest child should be given first. So Sakina takes the water. She takes the water pouch and she begins running towards the battlefield. Zainab stops her. Oh Sakina, where are you going? Sakina says, oh my auntie, you said that the youngest needs to be given water first. I am going to look for Asghar. Ali Asghar is the youngest. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Wa sayalamu alladhina zalamu ayyamun qalabin yanqalibun.